Hello everyone, welcome to the course on genetics. In this video we will learn about quantitative inheritance, a new concept in which we will discuss about the concept of quantitative inheritance, and also we will discuss about differences between qualitative and quantitative inheritance. So let us start with quantitative inheritance. Before understand quantitative inheritance, we should know what is qualitative inheritance. So Mendel considered the characters for his study which can be observed through naked eyes, for example tallness and dwarfness in plants. Such characters are known as qualitative characters. So all the Mendelian discoveries, they are dependent upon the qualitative inheritance, in which he chosen different types of characters which are easily observable by naked eyes. For example, in respect to height of plants, tallness is a character and dwarfness is a character. So these two characters are contrasting characters and alternate characters, means only two alternatives are there, either tallness or dwarfness. So no any intermediate will be formed there, and Mendel considered such characters. We can take another example. For example, if we take the example of flower color, there are two options, that is redness and whiteness. So these two characters are contrasting and alternate characters. So we know very well Mendel has selected such type of 7 different contrasting characters of the plants which were alternate to each other. So such type of easily observable characters by our naked eyes, these are called as qualitative characters. But quantitative characters are something other than these qualitative characters. There are many characters whose differences are not obvious. So some characters, they will not show clear cut differences in them, means we can't decide that is either that plant is tall or that plant is dwarf. But such plants are different types of phenotypes and they will show different types of variation. So such type of plants will exhibit differences of degree along a continuous scale of measurement. So there is no any fixed phenotype present in such plants. They show a degree of continuous scale of measurements. So such characters are known as quantitative characters or quantitative inheritance. So see here, there are some examples we can see. Quantitative traits characters are economically important measurable phenotypic traits or degree, such as yield of crop. So this is a character which is quantitative character, yield of crops, amount of flowers, fruits, seeds, milk, meat or egg produced by plants or animals, intelligence in human being, height, weight, shape, skin pigmentation, reproductive rate, behavior, eye factor, etc. So all these the characters which are known as quantitative characters, which will not show any type of contrasting characters or alternate characters, but they will show various phenotypic traits. For example, we can take amount of flowers produced by a plant. So there is no any fixed amount present in different types of plants. We can't say this plant will produce 20 flowers and this plant will produce only 10 flowers. So this alternation will not found in quantitative characters. Different plants will produce different flowers or different amount of flowers. Same thing is about fruits, seeds. Suppose milk production by any cow or any buffalo, it is also a different character. So there is also no any alternate characters present. Meat or egg produced by plants or animals. Intelligence in human being. Height. So there are different types of heights which will be shown by different types of plants and animals. Weight of the plant and any animal, it is also different. So all these characters which are not counted in the alternate way, but they can be measured, count by the scale, or they are counted by a particular unit. So these characters are called as quantitative characters. Then skin pigmentation, it is also a quantitative traits. So all these are the quantitative traits. Quantitative traits do not show clear-cut differences between individuals and forms a spectrum of phenotypes. So as we have seen, in qualitative traits we can identify plants, either it is tall, it is dark, but in quantitative traits we can't identify, recognize plant clearly by their differences. So the study of quantitative inheritance, it was started in early 20th century by different scientists. We will discuss about them in next slide. Quantitative traits, unlike qualitative traits, may be modified variously by the environmental condition and are usually controlled by many genes. So each contributing such a small amount of phenotype that their individual effect cannot be detected by Mendelian method, but by only statistical method. So see, quantitative traits or quantitative characters, or we may call quantitative inheritance, it is totally different than qualitative traits. So we know very well, qualitative traits, they are not modified by different types of environmental conditions. As if you see, if tallness is in the genotype of that seed, it will not be altered by any environmental conditions. That plant will grow tall only. Same thing is about dwarf plant, it will also not affected by any environmental condition. So this is in respect to qualitative traits, but quantitative traits, they can modify themselves according to the environmental conditions. And quantitative traits, unlike qualitative traits, they are controlled by many genes. And if we express or we try to express them differently or separately, they will not show any detectable difference. So such type of characters, such type of different genes, they contribute small amount in a phenotype, and all of these come together to form a phenotype. So such type of traits are known as quantitative traits and quantitative characters. So those genes which are non-allelic and affect the phenotype of a single quantitative traits are called as polygenes or cumulative genes. So different types of genes and different types of alleles will come together to form a particular phenotypic trait. It is known as the cumulative effect, or the genes are known as polygenes or cumulative genes, because all they come together to express a particular type of phenotype. So these are the quantitative genes. After that we will see what is multiple gene factor or multiple gene hypothesis, or some scientists say it as multiple factor hypothesis. So it is very easy concept. When many genes and their alleles contribute for a particular phenotypic expression, then it is known as multi-gene hypothesis or multiple allele hypothesis. Means for the expression of a particular phenotypic character, multiple genes, or we may call more than two genes, will come together, and such concept is known as multiple gene concept. Sometimes it is estimated, it is recorded that sometimes more than 10 to 100 genes come together to express a phenotypic trait or any particular phenotypic trait. There was a scientist, Nielsen Ill, 1908 to 1911 put forth the concept of multiple factor while doing his work on endosperm of maize and wheat. So first of all, he started his work on maize, and later on same results he found in wheat plants. In the same period, East from USA, East is the name of scientist, he was from USA, in 1910 he confirmed that the cumulative effect of these multiple genes expressed by increase in dimension of the concerned character. So Nelson L and East, they are working in similar period, and both confirmed the multiple gene hypothesis or multiple factor hypothesis. So East, in his study, he confirmed the cumulative effect of different types of genes in the expression of any character. So this is known as multiple gene factor. So here you can see cumulative effect of these multi genes expressed by increase in dimension of the concerned characters. Means if two genes will come together, they will give another effect, but one more or two genes are added into this, they will change or increase the dimension of concerned characters. Means the number of genes, if changes in a genotype, it will changes the phenotype. So this particular concept is called as multiple gene hypothesis. Now at last we will see what are the differences between qualitative trait and quantitative traits. So qualitative traits, first of all we will see it shows characters of kind and type. So qualitative traits will only see show character of kind or type, means red color flowers, white color flowers. So this is a character of kind, or it is character of type. In contrast to this, quantitative trait, it shows characters of degree. So it will not show any alternating characters as like qualitative traits, but it show character of degree. So how much genes are present there, they will decide what type of phenotype should be there. So this is known as character of degree. Now second point, it has qualitative trait, if you see, it has discontinuous variation and distinct phenotypic classes. So here if you see, there is discontinuous variation, means variation is not found at all here. Only red colored and pink colored plants will be, or flowers will be produced. In some cases, if they will show codominance, they will produce pink color flowers, but this is only limited to 2 to 3 phenotypic characters, and mostly they will show only alternating two characters, contrasting characters. So that it is called as discontinuous variation, means variation is discontinuous, it will not found continuously, and they show distinct phenotypic classes. So there will be only two phenotypic classes we will found, that is tallness or dwarfness. But here if you see in quantitative trait, it has continuous variation and a spectrum of phenotype. So continuous variation, why it is? Because the genes which are present in that offspring, they will decide the variation. If number of gene changes in the genotype of offspring, it will show variation. So such type of plants, such type of animals and such type of offspring will show continuous variation, and also it will show spectrum of phenotypes. Spectrum of phenotypes means many phenotypes. In here, in this case, we could see only two types of phenotypes will be produced, but here if you see, there are spectrum of phenotypes can be formed. Qualitative traits, in here single gene effect seen, but here multiple gene effect can be seen. Fourth point, it concerns with individual mating and their progeny. It concerns with population of organisms with all possible kinds of mating. So here we are taking in consideration only an individual, only a individual or two, but here we are concentrating upon the population. So whole population of that community we will take in consideration. So quantitative inheritance, it concerns with population of organisms with all possible kinds of mating. So here different types of organisms, they will mate randomly and they will produce different types of variation in that population. So this particular concept is called as quantitative inheritance. Last point, it can be analyzed by making counts and ratios. So in last few videos we have discussed about any type of such qualitative trait or qualitative cross, it can be counted or measured by different types of counts, that is counts we made of different types of offspring with different types of phenotypes. So suppose red flowered plant, white flowered plants, we can measure it, we can count it. Here also we will analyze them by using ratios. So we have used different types of ratio. For example, in mono hybrid cross we have seen 3:1 ratio. In dihybrid cross we have seen 9:3:3:1 ratio. And in interactions of genes we have noticed different types of ratios. And in this way qualitative traits or qualitative inheritance can be analyzed. But quantitative trait, it is not possible to analyze by this way, but it should be analyzed by measurement and statistical analysis of the offspring, because number of offspring is more and they show a spectrum of variation, and also different types of many genes contributes for that phenotypic trait. So the study of quantitative trait, it requires statistical analysis. So this is all about qualitative and quantitative traits. These are some references used for the presentation. Thank you for your attention.